Welcome inside the Macon Coliseum for the Georgia High School Association State Single-A Boys Public Championship game as the Calhoun County Cougars take on the Greenville Patriots. Matt Stewart along with Larry Smith. Larry, these two teams going for their third overall state championships. Greenville, their first since 1992, and Calhoun County, their first since 1997. So they're similar in that regard. They're also very similar in their approach as well. They like to play pressure defense, and coaches like to say that the way to beat a pressing team is to press them, so we see who can handle their own medicine here today.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's the thing, when you expect that when you get to this level, two very well-matched teams that we talked about a few moments ago in the pregame. When you look at these two again, both of them, again, go very deep as well, so stamina is going to be important, how your bench performs against these guys, and again, this is going to be so exciting. I think what the crowd here is outstanding. We had a great game here in the first game was outstanding. The girls won a public game. This one, I will tell you right now, we're about 90% capacity right here for this the second game of this state tournament weekend.
Both these teams are senior-laden. Calhoun County led by their senior guard, Quentin Taylor, who averages nearly 20 points per game.
Yeah, he's outstanding. Also, 9 rebounds as well. He's just been phenomenal. The way he goes, especially, is what Calhoun County, that's the way they're going to go, 29-2. He's helped them to a 19-game win streak already. Quentin Taylor, a senior, you mentioned, very deep, very experienced Greenville team, Calhoun team.
For Greenville, Jamal McKee leads the way. He's a 6'3 senior wing who averages about 20 points per game, but his real value to the team is he's the front man in the press.
Yeah, he's a wing, but you're right, but he's also one of the taller players on the team, and he's uber athletic as well. When you look at, again, what he does, he leaves the press. It's a 1-2-2 press, a full court press. They didn't go back into a zone. As you mentioned before, Coach really was talking about, again, this is a young man who really is going to dictate almost like the quarterback, the linebacker of their defense, if you will, and how they put this press on, this 1-2-2 press today.
Both these teams, they're region champions. Calhoun County, the champions out of Region 1 and the number one seed in the single-A bracket, and Greenville, the champions out of Region 4 and the number two seed.
Yeah, these two are outstanding. Sam Crenshaw is a third member of our team as well. Sam, what do you have for us?
Time before today's game, talking with Coach Walter Jackson from Greenville High School. He's a native of Warm Springs, and he went to high school at Manchester High School. Coached for a time at Columbus at Spencer. Basically, he's been in the same part of the state, but when he took the job at Greenville, he said nobody knew who he was. Mostly he's known for playing football in his days at Manchester High School. They'll no doubt remember him for a long, long time if he gets Greenville to a state champion the game today.
No doubt about it. He said when he took over, there was a lot of conditioning, Larry. In fact, the first 2 weeks of basketball practice, they didn't even get in the court. They just ran 5 miles a day and ran suicides. And everybody said, this man is crazy. But it was necessary to play their style of ball.
Yeah, he knew exactly what he was doing. And you're right, a lot of pushback on his style. Not everyone was feeling this. But look at where he has him right now. One win away from the state title. Take a look at the starters for these two. As we get ready to go now, five men Greenville, five men Calhoun, Greenville and White. And Matt, here we go.
Calhoun County Cougars in their red uniforms and the Greenville Patriots in the white trimmed in red and blue.
Just like that, the quick hands.
Quentin Taylor on the dribble. Their leading scorer, 19.5 points per game. Now Sherrod Williams up top. Long three-pointer, Rashawn Williams, the freshman, and the rebound controlled by Greenville and Jamal McKee. Ahead on the break, they beat the defense down the floor. Kamarcus Jackson lays it in.
He had a big game in the semifinals the other night. Again, they're so deep. Everyone on this team can score, and they all know their roles. Play together very well.
Sherrod Williams, the wild shot. Rebound controlled by Greenville, but they throw it away. In their haste to get out and run the break, they commit the turnover.
Yeah, well, the play before, Jackson did a nice job of leaking out ahead of time. Trying to make it happen again a little fast. Everyone kind of excited. Emotions here in the opening minute. They'll settle down.
Greenville 28-2 on the season. Calhoun County 29-2. Quentin Taylor knocks down the three-pointer.
Leading scorer for them, almost 20 points a game, as we mentioned. He's the senior player of the year in the region this year.
Back the other way, Jamal McKee takes his first shot. Underneath, the rebound controlled by Calhoun. Williams up the floor, goes all the way, misses the layup. Ball kept alive in the offensive glass by Calhoun, and Sherrod Williams puts it in.
Very athletic on defense. Look at both these teams, the way they go at it on defense. Both with the full court press.
McKee with the layup. First points for McKee, who averages 20.3 a game. And our first foul of the contest as well.
One more look at the play here under the basket again. Look at how, again, neither team very big. Biggest guy on the court right now, 6'3", but Sherrod Williams stays with it, gets the bucket.
Foul was called on Greenville's Quan Tenney. Shot blocked. Renault Griffin. Calhoun stays with it on the offensive glass, and a foul on the play.
Again, good defense right here. Watch here, just active hands. Griffin going up. He's only 6'1", plays bigger than that, though.
McKee was called for the foul. Jarek Solik at the foul line scored 27 points in their 87-65 semifinal win versus Troutland on Saturday. Solik averaging 8 points per game. Missed them both. Rebound controlled by Griffin. The first foul will be called on Calhoun.
Tell you what, we're just 2:15 into this game, but already it's as advertised. Both teams pressing, and right now both teams beating the press, getting down the court. I mean, there's no really, if you're a referee in this, there's no sense in trying to count to 10 to get across the line, because these teams are getting across that center court line in about 2 seconds.
John Tenney misses the free throw. Tenney averages 11.1 points per game and a 57% free throw shooter.
Both teams struggling at the line here in the opening minutes.
Williams with the left hand, nicely done. Williams with four of Calhoun's first 7 points. Great penetration. Underneath, McKee misses the follow-up and the rebound controlled by Calhoun and Rashawn Williams, and they throw it away.
They're going to call that off Calhoun. Here's the one last basket here, Sherrod Williams. Nice move right there to free himself. And then the left hand to avoid the shot block. Go ahead and get the ball.
7-5 lead Calhoun here in the opening. Close to 3 minutes. Our first substitutions of the ball game. DeJohn Williams checks in for Calhoun, and so does Deontay Scott. McKee takes the three and sinks it. McKee now with five in the ball game. Five of Greenville's eight. Back the other way very quickly. Clearing pass intercepted by Williams. Williams takes it all the way. Wild layup. Both these teams playing probably about a tick too fast for where they need to be right now. I know they're excited during the state championship game, but a little bit out of control, a little bit sloppy right now.
Well, most of the turnovers, you're right, are self-inflicted right now because they're trying to play too fast. To your point, Matt. Take a deep breath. If it's not there,
I know
it's a 32-minute game.
I know you want to attack the basket,
right?
But do it under control. That's McKee right at the elbow. Offensive rebound and the stick back by Marcus Jackson. He has four. Greenville leads by three.
Nice job by Jackson. That's what you hear about it again. There's a turnover again. Somehow Calhoun keeps that ball. I thought it was off. It was off of Taylor.
Now watch their press here, and watch number 15, Jamal McKee. He's the guy they called Gator. He's the guy at the top of the press, and he has the option to trap anybody he wants to in the backcourt. There he goes. Track fails, however, as they break the press. They've got a 2-on-1. And the jumper knocked down by Deshaun Williams. I was a little dubious with that shot that he didn't pass to the wing, but he knocked down the shot. McKee gets fouled from behind by Deontay Scott.
Now, earlier that last basket by Greenville, I was going to say nice job by Jackson of just really setting up and getting inside the position, blocking out his man. Easy rebound and the putback.
Timeout on the floor, 4:17 to play in the opening quarter. Greenville for 1-point lead on Calhoun County.
Cotton farmers want you to know cotton is grown in 91 Georgia counties on over 1 million acres. Cotton makes a $2.5 billion economic impact and accounts for over 15,000 jobs in Georgia. Cotton's innovative production has lowered water use per pound of cotton by 75% since 1980. One bale of cotton can make 215 pairs of denim jeans or 700 towels. Cotton is a natural choice for Georgia.
4:17 to play in the opening quarter, the single-A public state championship game. Greenville on top of Calhoun County, 10-9. Take a look at head coach Marcus Scott in his fifth season as the Cougars' head coach. Marcus Shaw, pardon me, in his fifth season as the Cougars' head coach. And Larry, let's take a look at their keys to the game.
Well, the keys right now for Calhoun, again, you got to make McKee miss. We've seen him already hit a three-pointer, and right now he's going to the line when we resume play. And again, handle this Greenville pressure. Again, we talked about Greenville and Coach Jackson. He referenced those great 90s Arkansas teams and the 40 minutes of H, as he said. He says, we play 32 minutes of H here. But that pressure for Greenville really right now has been outstanding. And trying to control the tempo.
Walter Jackson in his first season as the Greenville head coach and their keys to the game.
Yeah, I mentioned again, sorry for Calhoun, but he mentioned the same thing. You got to stop Quentin Taylor, the star guard, almost 20 points per game for Calhoun. Deal with the Calhoun's quickness as well. Again, we've talked about this before. We say it again. It's like these two looking in at the mirror. Not very big, but both go 9-10 men deep. And both, again, very quick, and they both like the pressure full court and create some turnovers. That's the key, really. They both the same duties for both these coaches, both these teams.
Jamal McKee at the line now has 6 of Greenville's first 11 points.
Calhoun cannot afford to let him get his points tonight.
Well, he's a matchup problem for teams because he's big and can play outside, and he's quick and can play inside. So he causes big problems. Great defense underneath by Greenville, and they come away with the ball. Ahead to McKee. And McKee, great control. He's got the layup. McKee with 8, Greenville's first 13, and the Patriots have a 4-point lead. Williams gets fouled on the play by Quentin Taylor. Jamon Middlebrooks.
Watch this fast break here again. That's Taylor there in the middle. The fast break quickly gets it up to McKee. Actually, Jamon Middlebrooks was on that play right there. It's just both of these teams playing very active. But great defense by Greenville. Even when Calhoun breaks the press, they do a very nice job of setting up and forcing jump shots or forcing tough shots inside, and that's why they have the lead right now. I think at the moment for Greenville, Coach Walter Jackson has to like the way his team is playing once they've kind of settled down and taken care of the ball once they do make a defensive stop.
Sherrod Williams, 13 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists per game, and missed both the free throws. Greenville comes out of there running. Baseline jumper knocked down by Tamarcus Jackson. He has 6.
Great look there by Quan Tenney, but once again, they break the press. But see then, there Calhoun makes an unforced error right there, a bad pass at the knees.
It was an unforced error, but if we can see the replay, Tamarcus Jackson ran at the dribbler. He took his eyes off the ball, looked at Tamarcus Jackson, and fumbled it out of bounds.
So again, the Greenville defense doing a nice job.
An indirect turnover out of that pressure defense. Greenville on a 10-2 run to take a 6-point lead. McKee on the drive. Missed the floater. Rebound controlled by Deshaun Williams. Greg Williams. He has scored six of their 11. Air ball to Marcus Jackson, and Williams the rebound. Lobs ahead for Middlebrooks. Quentin Taylor, pardon me. And inside, we have a foul on Greenville.
That defense, again, we're talking about. Watch this right here. Like you were saying, he takes his eyes away from the ball. Middlebrooks is right there. And when he does that, the bad pass there at the knees goes off his leg, and it's a turnover going the other way for Greenville. The Greenville press really doing a very nice job during this first quarter.
Dejon Williams at the line. Dejon Williams averaging 10 points, 5 rebounds, couple of assists per game.
Mike Snelling checking in, number 4 for Greenville. Again, both these teams really using their bench very liberally. Keep up the pace.
So Dejon Williams with 4. He and Sherrod Williams, 6. They've combined for 10 of Calhoun County's 12 points. Offensive rebound. That was Henry who slipped in underneath. McKee takes a 3. Henry gets the offensive rebound again. A couple of rebounds offensive for Brendarius Henry on that possession to get the points for Greenville.
Right now, Greenville's winning the energy game right now. They're going after it. They want a little bit more. A lot of contact there. Nothing called.
Back to McKee. Nicely done. Blew the layup. And then, after getting the rebound, Rashawn Williams stepped out of bounds.
Again, just energy right now. That was a great give and go at 2-on-1 break right now as McKee gets a deserved break here in the final 2:03 here in the first quarter. He just couldn't finish it.
Jackson knocks down the 3 to Marcus Jackson. Army. That was Mike Snelling. And a 7-point lead for Greenville.
Yeah, they brought Snelling in already. That's his second 3-pointer. They were trying in that last possession in the half court, trying to get the ball to him on the wing. They managed to do that just then, get it to him in the corner. 20-13, Greenville right now. Again, they average 81 points a game. We're seeing what they can do right here.
GPB's longest-running local show, Georgia Traveler, continues to scour the Peach State for all the newest, oldest, weirdest, and wildest attractions for you and your family to explore. Watch Georgia Traveler Fridays at 8 and look forward to a special episode on Friday, April 3rd that's all about golf. Greenville on a 10-4 run, knocked out of bounds by Renault Griffin.
Griffin right now, he's the tall man, and he's taking the place at that gator position, the point of that 1-2-2 full court press with McKee on the bench.
Calhoun 6 of 15 from the floor to start the game, and a foul's going to be called on Greenville.
They're calling it out of bounds.
Oh, wow.
I'm trying to say he lost it first.
Lost it out of bounds, and that's a turnover for Rashawn Williams. Intercepted, Sherrod Williams. Williams and one.
Great play right there. He's really keeping Calhoun County in this game. Great defense here. It's like a defensive back, like a safety back there. And the great left hand right there to avoid the shot block and a chance for a 3-point play.
Really like what we've seen from Sherrod Williams so far, a very physical 6'2", 190-pound senior guard. He has scored 8 of Calhoun County's first 15 points.
He's really kept them in the game on both ends of the court as McKee's about to come in next dead ball for Greenville.
Trouble with the free throws, though. Henry misses the 3, got his own miss. That's 3 offensive rebounds for Brendarius Henry since he got to the ballgame.
See, once again, that ball's out of bounds off Greenville, but again, Calhoun is out of control. Once they do break the press, that's where they've got to make better decisions once they have the advantage, the two-on-one. Good defense right here. This is Henry making it something happen on the other end, knocking the ball away. Calhoun scores.
Yeah, Quentin Taylor off the inbounds, nicely executed on the inbounds play, knocks down the three-pointer, and Calhoun County's back within three, and then Greenville throws it away on their offensive end. Well, that's one of the things, Larry, about the pressure defense. It speeds you up, so if they don't get the direct turnover, such as a steal or blocked pass or something like that, you get the indirect turnover where you throw it out of bounds by yourself and dribble the ball off your knee or your foot.
Yeah, exactly. Either way, it works for you.
As you can see there, with the Calhoun bench, again, the turnover's already seven. We expect that. Just to the replay of that quick three-pointer, as you mentioned, off the inbound. Nice job right there. Quentin Taylor, leading scorer. Nice, well-designed play. They're back in this ballgame.
Calhoun has hit three of their last four, while Greenville has gone one for their last seven from the floor. And that's why the Calhoun County Cougars have been able to climb back to within 2 points of the Greenville Patriots. Well, much of what we expected. We're on pace for about an 80-point game. And remember, this is a 32-minute game, not a 40-minute game like college basketball or a 48-minute like the NBA. So they're scoring. They don't need a shot clock. They don't need a 24-second shot clock. Nicely executed by Calhoun County. Reginald Ross with the basket.
That was a great look by Salitz to make it happen. Ron Tenney, chance for a three-point play.
Ross was called for the foul, and that's his second. On the previous basket, pardon me, it was Rashawn Williams and not Ross with the basket, and Tenney completes the three-point play. Jamal McKee back in the ballgame for Greenville. Break the press again, get it across half court, traveling. And there's another one of the indirect turnovers that come from that pressure defense. You get the ball into the hands of somebody who's not ready for it, and they travel.
I tell you what, it almost will be worth it for them once you get it across, just to wait and set up in a half court, because they've turned the ball over more than they've scored or gotten points once they do get it past.
You're right. They've been much more effective in their half court offensive set than they have been scoring on the break. Final 24 seconds of the first quarter.
Notice that neither team is, Calhoun County has no problem sitting and waiting, getting a quick breather here. They're waiting for the last shot.
Everybody's taking some deep breaths out there.
That's
they're
right.
Thankful that they're playing for the final shot here at the end of this quarter. Nearly stolen. Long three ball with 2 seconds, an offensive rebound.
Oh.
And McKee at the buzzer. They will count it. Jamal McKee with the tip at the buzzer, his 10th point of the quarter, and Greenville's got a 5-point lead after 8 minutes.
Boy, what an unbelievable finish here to this frenetic first quarter. Look at this one more time. There's that shot almost went in, but again, McKee, he's got great position, and that's the thing again. I'm really impressed with Greenville and their positioning on offensive rebounds, blocking out the defenders, getting good position. And that's why they're able to get two different looks at it right there. The offensive rebounds, and then put back for a 5-point lead here at the end of the first quarter, Matt.
Greenville with a 25-20 lead on Calhoun County as they go for their first state title since 1992.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Animal agriculture is important to Georgia. Our farmers work hard each and every day to take care of our animals across this state. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, President of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association. Just as we teach our children to work hard and accomplish goals, we take care of each other like a family. We as farmers across this state love our animals, and we work hard to take care of them too, don't we, Jen?
Visit us online at gfb.org.
This isn't Madison Square Garden. These drills probably won't make anyone a number one draft pick. But these players are practicing for something important. While they work on their jump shots, they're also learning teamwork, discipline, self-confidence, how to deal with wins and losses. Skills that will make them winners long after they leave the court. Support high school activities in your community. Because when kids take part, they get set for life.
Right now I'm about 100 feet high, traveling at about 50 miles an hour, just thinking about where I should go next. If you have any ideas, visit us on our Georgia Traveler Facebook page. Gotta go!
Today, companies in the aerospace, advanced manufacturing, and film industries need skilled workers, and the earning potential is high. Go Build Georgia can show you where the jobs are and what skills you need to get them. And the Technical College System of Georgia has fast, affordable training for these great-paying careers. Build your blueprint for success at GoBuildGeorgia.com and look to the Technical College System of Georgia to put your plan into action.
Start of the second quarter. Greenville with a 25-20 lead on Calhoun County here in the single-A boys public state championship game. Matt Stewart along with Larry Smith. And Larry, one thing Calhoun County's absolutely got to clean up for the rest of this game is their free throw shooting. They missed 5 out of 7 free throws in that first quarter.
Yeah, you're not going to do it. You've got those just free points. You've got to find a way to make those happen. Also, they've got to really, again, block out underneath 10 points off turnovers for Greenville. 6 second chance points as well.
3-point basket, Deontay Scott. First points of the ball game for Deontay Scott. Calhoun County down only 2. They've hit 7 of their last 10 shots dating back to the end of the first quarter. McKee on the drive, and the rebound controlled by Calhoun. Linton Taylor brings the ball up the floor. He'll launch a 3. Quick shot right there. They don't waste time. Ahead and blows the layup. McKee had a shot blocked.
Nice play by Scott.
And a block on the other end by Griffin, but a foul is going to be called. Griffin with 3 block shots. Or pardon me, 2 block shots in that first quarter. This time he gets called for the foul.
Both up and down. Let me tell you something, this crowd also very entertained. A lot of the fans from the first game sticking around to watch these two go up and down the court. There's another one. 2 of 8.
2 of 8, and Solit is 0 for 3. That was just tough luck right there. Had too much English as the ball spun off the rim. 1-point lead for Greenville after Solit gets 1 of 2. McKee. And that's going to be a blocking foul.
I tell you what, he's a big, strong kid, 6'3", but he does a really nice job with body control. When he goes in, he knows the defender's going to come in and try to take the charge. Every time he does, if you watch him, he finds a way to get around that defender. He did it right then, couldn't get the basket to go, but the blocking foul called. Now a couple of free throws.
11th point of the ball game for Jamal McKee.
The coach said that he makes things go. We talked to him the other day, and no question, on both ends, a lot of energy. Watch him now hurry.
Greenville contrasting Calhoun struggles at the free throw line. Greenville's 5 for 7 at the free throw line. Dejon Williams barely grazed the iron. Underneath, Williams again had the ball slip out of his hands. Quinton Taylor in there and finally sticks it in.
But I like their energy. They got to hurry back now on defense, but I like their energy. That's the first time that they won the battle for the ball up underneath the basket. Greenville is really controlled on both sides, but a great job right here. Check the replay. Watch this. You know, Dejon didn't make that happen right there, but I like that he stayed with it. Dejon Williams. And later on, again, there it is. Quinton Taylor with the putback.
Foul was called on Sherrod Williams down here on the offensive end for Greenville, fouled on Calhoun County. And the ball, last touch by Calhoun. Quinton Taylor got his fingers on it. Opening 90 seconds of the second quarter, single A boys state championship game. Off the inbound, missed by Jackson. Gerard Williams behind the back of the open floor. They slow it down for a moment, but only for a moment. Quinton Taylor with the scoop shot, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Greenville.
I do like the moment of patience, Matt. You mentioned it was just a moment. It's brief.
Renault Griffin is called for his second personal foul.
By the way, the people, everyone watching at home around the state, we've got a better vantage point of the score and time than the people here in the arena. The center scoreboard is broken. It's still stuck on 8 minutes to start the second quarter. Still says 25-20 Greenville.
Seven team fouls now on Greenville, so Calhoun County in the bonus for the rest of the half. Five team fouls on Calhoun County. Quinton Taylor now with a team-leading 9 points.
Good-looking player.
He was the Region Player of the Year in Region 1 single A.
Calhoun County taking the lead. They weather the storm.
John Williams called for the foul at the elbow up high after he grabbed the rebound. Number one on him. McKee, three. Got his own missed and had it stolen away. Ahead, Sherrod Williams, a one on two. Empty. They just go right at each other. Quan Kenny with the layup.
No hesitation.
There's the press. And that's an offensive foul. Good job by Greenville to draw it. I don't know how much contact there was, but he sold it well. Quan Kenny, let's see.
Look at it again. Well, it's hard to tell. Wow.
So that's going to be a third personal foul. Foul is called on DeJohn Williams.
Yeah. From his vantage point, he really couldn't see it. One more look at it right here. He puts, it's a good acting job right there by Quan Tenney. Too bad the Academy Awards have already gone, come and gone. But hey, there's always next year. We can get nominated.
Inbounds intended for McKee. Greenville still controls it. And Jackson, nice feed from up top, coming from Quan Tenney.
Tough break for Calhoun County. Did a nice job defensively there. Ball didn't bounce their way.
Scott, the miss.
Again, active hands by Greenville.
Wow, there is so much contact. This is like arena football out here.
It really, I was going to say the same thing. It really is. I was going to say, we need to get these guys some pads and helmets. Both sides really with great energy right now. I like that Calhoun fell behind early, but they understand again, Coach Shaw, getting them to keep playing hard. It's a 32-minute game. Got to stay with it.
Jamon Middlebrooks at the foul line for Greenville. Air ball. He's a 43% free throw shooter, and now you know why. There's the trap, produces the turnover. And a hard foul underneath, and Quan Tenney will be going to the foul line, and that's going to be a foul on Reginald Ross.
Yeah, these guys are on the floor so much, they need to try to find somebody volunteer to take a towel and kind of pop up some spots here. But again, incredibly Greenville crowds, we talked about Jamal McKee and all that he does, number 15. He's the one that created that turnover. And a chance now to get some points at the line.
Daquan Timmy averaged 11 points per game during the season, but just 6.3 during the playoffs, but his assists are up from 3.1 to 5.3 in the playoffs. He's a guy that can fill it up. He had a 33-point game and an 84-82 loss against Pacelli during the regular season. Greenville back on top by five. And a timeout. Great hustle right there by Quan Tinney. He just simply outraced DeAndre Scott for the ball, hopped on top of it and called a timeout. So a timeout with 5:06 to play in the first half. Greenville on top by five.
This moment, getting here took 3 years of sleepless nights and postponed vacations. Your dad said, play it safe. Your husband kept the faith. But franchising is why you partnered with Regions in the first place. We share your vision for moving forward. And at moments like this,
hi, Steve.
That makes all the difference. Is your business at a turning point? Regions.
Calhoun County down five to Greenville. The Cougars going for their first state championship since 1997. Got their first state title way back in 1972. 2 of 9 shooting for Calhoun County here in the second quarter. Greenville 2 of 7.
Already two. The number stands out for me, Matt. 5 minutes to go here as the center scoreboard finally is fixed for those here in the arena here in Macon. 14 points off turnovers now for Greenville, just 7 for Calhoun. That's the difference in this game right now.
Yeah, Calhoun County has committed 11 turnovers, leading to those 14 points. Contrast that, Greenville 6 turnovers, and Calhoun County's gotten 7 out of those. Backdoor cut, blew the layup. That was nicely executed, but Mike Snelling didn't handle his end of the bargain.
Smart move there by Williams. Hold on to the ball, set up in the half court.
Shot blocked. Good defense by Greenville. Long outlet comes ahead to Quan Tinney. And Tinney banks it in. 7-point lead for Greenville. This matches their largest lead of the game. Sherrod Williams answers with a layup.
Nice movement of control right there by Sherrod Williams with the right hand.
Wow, he was way off on his three that time. Left-handed layup scooped up and in by Quentin Taylor. 12 for Taylor. Calhoun County, 4 consecutive points after Greenville had gone on a 7-0 run. That's kind of been the story of the game. Greenville makes a run. Calhoun County battles back. DeMarcus Jackson with the jumper. He becomes the second Greenville Patriot to reach double figures, joining McKee with 12. Jackson's got 10. The drive by Quentin Taylor. The foul's going to be called on Greenville. I believe this is on McKee. No, number 14, not number 15. DeMarcus Jackson picks up his second personal. Quentin Taylor, 2 for 2 at the foul line. The rest of the team's 3 for 9.
Facial resemblance to Bill Bellamy. Sure, he's as funny as Bill, but he's a better ball player.
Quentin Taylor, 10 points, 2 rebounds, 3 of 5 from the floor, 2 of 3 on his threes, and now 2 of 3 at the foul line.
Notice right now, Calhoun County not even going to the full court press, trying to lay back in the half court.
offensive foul on Greenville.
Oh, well, look at this right here. Henry out of control. Nice job right there.
Jalen Gray is able to draw that foul. There's the full court press. Quentin Taylor able to get by McKee. Long pass ahead. Foul called on Greenville. This will be on Jamar Middlebrooks.
Great no-look pass right here by Taylor. Watch this. We've seen this a couple of times. Jalen Gray goes to the line shooting two.
Charles Dunn blows the whistle, and steps over to the scorer's table.
I'm not sure Coach Marcus Shaw of Calhoun County had a complaint. Not sure what. The clock was still rolling, so they're trying to look at that now and determine if they're going to change it, and it looks like they're not. They'll stay at 3:15.
Jalen Gray at the line, averages just 2 points, three rebounds per game, a 6'2", 255-pound junior center.
That's a nice bounce.
They need a nice bounce with the way they've been shooting free throws. They could use a little help.
Hey, it's four in a row overall. Didn't Taylor hit both of his?
He hit one of two.
Okay. Almost.
A three out of four is better than what they had.
Sure.
There's the drive and one. Juan Tenney takes it strong to the basket and gets the foul called on Calhoun County.
One more look at this right here. Nice pick right there by McKee. Freezes the defense with a hesitation dribble. It's a nice job right there on the pick and roll. The defense had to respect McKee in the lane. Tenney goes in, chance out for three-point play. Nice job by the two seniors.
Tenney now with 9 points. Stays there. The foul is called on Jalen Gray. 4-point lead, Greenville. Jalen Gray goes right at the basket.
And a nice no-look by Taylor on the assist. Calhoun County staying in the game.
Yeah, he didn't play at all in the first quarter, making the most of his time here in the second quarter. Left open on the baseline, and the bounce goes the way of Jamon Middlebrooks.
Paul McKee for a foul there in the open court.
That'll be his second. The key to their press is keeping McKee out of foul trouble. In their semifinal game against Hancock Central, they were down 59-58. And Walter Jackson gambled and stuck McKee back in the ball game with four fouls, and he was able to turn that one-point deficit into a 75-68 semifinal win, and that's how Greenville got to the state championship game.
No free throw problems. Taylor missing the first.
Three-point lead. That's nearly an over and back. McKee falls hard at half court, slow getting up. Tenney, spin move, pass out of bounds to nobody.
Out of control there. Nice job of the Calhoun defense. I like that right now they're in the game. They're setting back and not trying to press at the moment. Just sit back and play good, solid half-court defense. I want to see them work those boards a little more, too.
Cardinal rule, don't leave your feet unless you know what you're going to do with the basketball. You get up there, and, man, you got to get rid of it because you're coming down. You either got to shoot or pass. In that case, he was close enough to the basket, should have just taken the shot. Layup blown and missed by Quentin Taylor after McKee had gambled for the steal. How many point blank shots has Calhoun County had underneath and free throws that they've missed?
Yeah, I'd say at least a half dozen here in the first half, man. Quite a few.
On the baseline, Quentin Taylor stepped out of bounds.
A lot of turnovers here for Calhoun County. It's nine.
.140 to play in the half.
Middlebrooks. Shot blocked by Quentin Taylor, but Greenville stayed with it and gets the basket. 5-point lead again. McKee now with 14. Air ball, three-pointer from Williams. I'm going to say it's off Calhoun County.
So Greenville has led by as much as seven on several occasions here in this first half, and they can take it back up to seven or eight on this possession here in the final minute. Henry, that's going to be a blocking foul on Gray of Calhoun County.
Greenville's quickness right now as we take a look at this again. Henry, watch it here on the drive. He puts his shoulder down, but look at Gray moving his feet. They'll call that every time.
Second foul on Gray. Henry, a 66% free throw shooter during the season. That's his third point of the game. Henry averaged just under 8 points per game, rolls in the second. Again, a 7-point lead for Greenville. Nice no-look from Salih and the basket by Gray. How about the no-look pass from Jarek Salih?
Yeah, nice job right there. Good no look. He's done that a couple of times now.
Gray, 6 points, all of them in the second quarter. Henry, the drive. Thrown away. Taylor up the floor. Scoops it up and in. Calhoun County with a nice little run here in the final minute. Back the other way. Missed by Tenney. Five on the clock. Taylor splits the defense and gets the layup.
A great finish by Calhoun County, and their star player, Quentin Taylor, he's got the Cougars right back in this game. Back-to-back fast break layups. What a sequence in the final 30 seconds now.
6 points from Calhoun County in the final 30 seconds.
Now here's the first one here. He puts it in. They let Tenney go all the way in. He misses, but then Taylor, great body control right there. He shows you the dexterity. Right hand on the first basket, left hand on the second. And the Cougars were down seven, and all of a sudden, there they are. You've got them right there, back to a one-point game here at halftime.
Let's go over to Sam Crenshaw.
All right, here with Coach Jackson from Greenville. Definitely didn't like the things you saw there at the end of the half.
Yeah, we're sloppy. Not protecting the ball, not getting back on defense. That's not us right there. I think the crowd has gotten a little to our players. We got to sell them now. Once we rebound, protect the ball, we'll be fine. I mean, we'll be fine.
I know you love to see through the defense from end to end. Didn't see a lot of that in the first half. You did it in spurts. Thoughts about what you're going to do to get things in the second half?
Yeah, well, it's the pace of our pace. We like that. See, 44, 45, if the game continues this pace, it'll be 94. I mean, we this is our pace. This is what we want. But we got to play defense, protect the ball, and rebound a little better than we're doing. Sloppy on the other end.
That's what we look for in the second half.
Well, just go in this locker room, calm this team down, and make them play ball, make them play the game that we're capable of playing, and don't let this crowd get next to them. They're too hyped. I have to go in there as a coach and calm them down.
All right, let's see you go to work then.
Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate
it. Thanks so much. That is Coach Walter Jackson of Greenville. Got to get his team calmed down. They still have a one-point lead as we're at halftime.
Hey, Sam, great job. I love to hear the coach get that enthusiastic and that emphatic and that passionate about what he's going to tell his kids before he goes to the half.
He had a lot to say there, so I can only imagine what he's saying during the half.
All right,
we got some social media coming your way. Also, first half highlights as we head to halftime of Game 2, Championship Week here on GPB.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
You can't think about service in Georgia without thinking about our brave men and women in uniform. I'm here today with the Georgia National Guard, and we're very proud of them and their families and how they represent our state. At Georgia Farm Bureau, we're proud about the service we deliver to you and your family and to Georgia agriculture. We invite you to come to your local Farm Bureau office and join our family.
Take advantage of Farm Bureau's many services, from multi-line insurance to money-saving discounts. Visit us online at gfb.org.
There's just one place where students are students first, and athletics are played with purpose and perspective. That place is your local high school. High school sports offer more than the joy of competition. Studies show that student athletes are also likely to enjoy greater levels of achievement in other areas of their lives, including academics. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education.
Joe gets up at 7 a.m., washes his face, gets dressed, grabs breakfast to go. He then patiently waits for the bus, chats up his classmates, goes to school, doesn't go in. Great act, Joe, but you're only fooling yourself.
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend, only on GPB.
Screaming Eagle Zipline Canopy Adventures at historic Banning Mills, holder of two Guinness World Records. Lodging, adventure, history, and Nature Conservancy, all just 45 minutes west of Atlanta.
Welcome back to our GPB Halftime Show. We'll be with you for 33 hours this week, 9 or so today and tomorrow, and then 14 big hours on Saturday as we crown 14 state champions here in the state of Georgia.
And we're at halftime of the boys' single-A public game, like Mark just said, between Greenville and Calhoun County. You've heard a lot about what we have to say throughout the game so far. Now it's time to check in with some of what our fans are saying. So we're going to walk over to this new nifty bell and whistle, you could say. We've got over here our social media screen. This is where we're going to display everything that you fans are saying when you're interacting and engaging with us. We're at GPB Sports on Twitter. We're also on Facebook, and we're on Instagram. That's where we're bringing you all the behind-the-scenes action. So like I said, we've got Twitter and we've got Facebook going. Here's a tweet from Mardamian Height, who says, this is going to be one of those epic finishes. So they're excited to see how this game winds up in those final minutes. And then America's Got Style, another tweeter, says, go Calhoun County Cougars. Very proud of you all. Bring home that state championship today. So we've got a lot of people tweeting. And we've told you that you can watch the games online at gpb.org/sports all over the world. We've had viewers before watching from Afghanistan, watching from Iraq, watching from areas of Europe, Australia, all over the place. So if you know anybody watching around the world or around the country, let us know. Or if you're watching from someplace far away, let us know on social media. That's what we've got going on here. Back over to you, Mark.
All right. Thanks very much, Grace Olson. We're going to check in now with the Georgia EMC scoreboard. And, of course, one champion has already been crowned. It was a historic championship as Taylor County wins its 11th state championship, most ever, beating Turner County 67-54. Right now, we're in the middle of a great barn burner here. There's a big, enthusiastic crowd here at the Macon Centroplex. Greenville leads Calhoun County 45-44. Coming up next, Buford, winners of three state champions, takes on the Lady Trojans of Carrollton, who won back in 2009. And then in Class 4A, the defending champion boys team, the Cardinals of Jonesboro, will take on the Carrollton Trojans, looking for their first ever state championship.
time for the career play of the game presented by the Technical College System of Georgia. Not every career keeps you cooped up in an office. Fields like agriculture, wildlife management, and forestry are perfect for anyone who loves working in those great outdoors. Agribusiness is the oldest industry in the state. It's still economically viable, but today's agricultural careers require training and skills. Forestry is another outdoor career that's moving into the 21st century. New harvesting techniques require professional training. Careers are waiting for anyone ready to get out and to work, and that's why working in the great outdoors is our career play of the game. This message is brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia. Visit tcsg.edu for more information. Mark?
All right. You ready for the second half of this one?
I'm ready. It's been an exciting one so far. It's kind of chippy out there. I'm excited to see what happens.
It is. 45-44. We're going to come back with the second half of the single-A public school championship game between Calhoun County and Greenville.
Don't go anywhere. Matt Stewart and Larry Smith are up next with first half highlights and stats in the second half. It's all coming up next on the Great GBB. It's GHSA Championship Weekend.
Attention high school students and parents. Going to college is expensive, but at College Goal Georgia events, students can get help filling out the free application for federal student aid to get money for college. Participants can also enter to win an iPad. Visit collegegoalga.com.
Georgia cotton farmers want you to know cotton is grown in 91 Georgia counties on over 1 million acres. Cotton makes a $2.5 billion economic impact and accounts for over 15,000 jobs in Georgia. Cotton's innovative production has lowered water use per pound of cotton by 75% since 1980. One bale of cotton can make 215 pairs of denim jeans or 700 towels. Cotton is a natural choice for Georgia.
In a state with a dropout rate scary high, students are vanishing. What can you do to stop the drop? Visit gpb.org/stopthedrop for more information.
Right now I'm about 100 feet high, traveling at about 50 miles an hour, just thinking about where I should go next. Do you have any ideas? Visit us on our Georgia Traveler Facebook page. Gotta go!
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend, only on GPB.
Start of the second half and third quarter, Greenville Patriots leading the Calhoun County Cougars 45-44 in the single-A public boys state championship game from the Macon Coliseum. Matt Stewart along with Larry Smith. And what a frenetic first half. Much of what we expected in this first half, but at times teams out of control. But 90 points scored, or 89 points, right at 90 points scored in that first half total.
And you're right, it is what we expected. A lot of action, high flying when you look at the two stars of what these guys did. How about first off, Jamal McKee? He's the guy, player we wanted to look at, and what he does on both ends of the court here for Greenville. And he was really a man among boys. Watch him here again. The great body control there for the layup. Shoots from the outside, hits a three as well. 14 points for him, but only 5 of 16 shooting. And Middlebrooks, the young man as well, for the other side. Middlebrooks, I should say, for Greenville, had a nice job. But also, this is a Quentin Taylor, and the job that he did, and those two baskets late in the final seconds, final 20 seconds in that first half. What a nice job. 18 points. He's got he's the leading scorer in this game here in the first half.
Yeah, it's just a one-point difference in this contest. The real significant difference, if you want to call it that, statistically, is the four extra missed free throws by Calhoun County, although they did start to clean up their free throw shooting late in that second quarter.
Yeah, they did. 12 turnovers right there, but again, Greenville with 9 on the other side. 3-point field goals there are big. I think, again, the points in the paint, those layups have really helped that. 24 points each side, 16 points off turnovers for Greenville. Another big difference right now. But look, we've got a 1-point game here in the first half. What an outstanding title game we have here in the boys' Class A public final.
Greenville starts on offense. They're in the white, Calhoun County in the red. 3-ball on its way, and the offensive rebound and missed by Greenville. And that's going to be an offensive foul on Quentin Taylor. And that'll be number 3 on Quentin Taylor. Taylor with 18 points on 6 of 9 shooting, 2 of 3 on his threes, and 4 of 6 at the foul line. And he spurred that big 6-0 rally in the last 30 seconds of the second quarter.
Another clock problem is, again, the center clock above the court is not working. Officials letting everyone know, make sure they look at the ones on the side. Your clock, you're watching at home, is correct.
Jackson off the mark, rebound controlled by Solit. Solit with the team-high 6 rebounds for Calhoun County. Jalen Gray, who had a big second quarter, starts off the third quarter big for Calhoun County, and they lead. They've led for only 2 minutes in this entire game, and now they lead here early in the third quarter.
I think that end, that flourish there at the end of the first half has really sparked the Cougars. Nice job here.
That's going to be a foul on Gray right there.
8-0 run going back to the end of the second quarter.
It's foul number 3 on Gray. Gray's played only 5 minutes in this game in the first half.
It feels like he's played more than that.
Well, he's made himself present since getting in the ball game. Didn't even play in the first quarter. Tamarcus Jackson. Greenville now 9 of 14 at the foul line.
Maybe it's this end of the court. Well, this is the basket that Calhoun County had its troubles on in the first half.
This is the bad rim.
Yeah, it's the bad rim. It's been something happened.
Marcus Jackson, 10 points, couple of rebounds in that first half. He came up big for him in their win against Hancock Central in the semifinals on Saturday. 10 of his 16 points in the fourth quarter, also matched his season high with 8 rebounds in that huge victory. And we're tied at 46. Solit blows by everybody and puts it in.
That was a nice job by Solit. Great job by Taylor to hold on to the ball. He actually slipped and tried to throw it. Fell out of bounds. Bounce right to Solit.
Snelling the miss. Greenville now 2 for 12 on their threes. Taylor, nice throw! And Solit sticks it in. Highlight pass from Quentin Taylor, putting on a show here in Macon, Georgia.
Like that. He's putting on a highlight reel today with his assists.
This is the biggest lead of the game, and then an answer by Tamarcus Jackson to cut it back to 1.
And one more look at this. Check this out. The 360 spin. Not sure how he got that ball away. One more look at it here. He spins, actually throws the ball before the spin. Ooh, that's pretty. Great ball control right there.
Then he gets stripped in the next possession. Tamarcus Jackson up the floor. Snelling is really struggling with his shot here. Snelling's already 0 for 3 in this quarter. And Sherrod Williams back the other way and lays it in. Calhoun County with a 4-point lead. Foul's going to be called on Calhoun County.
Sherrod Williams.
Yep, number 2 on him.
McKee. A little frustration there. Could have been called for a foul.
So Lee goes right by the defense again. Snelling didn't do much to get in front of him. Calhoun County, our biggest lead of the ball game, as they jumped out on top, 54-48. Calhoun County now starting to make their move here in the opening 2.5 minutes of the second half.
What is by moonlight an empty field is by the magic of electricity, sacred ground. As the official energy provider of the GHSA, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives proudly support our student athletes. We are there, illuminating the glory moments fans just have to see. Capturing the hustle, elevating champions, sharing the win. Georgia's EMCs, empowering our youth, lighting the way.
Calhoun County on a 16-3 run since they trailed by 7 with a minute to play in the second quarter.
And here's how they're doing it. Take a look at this. Again, good active play. Great look there. We can't see that more too often. Great assist there by Taylor. Sherrod Williams in a big first half. His first bucket here after halftime. And then again, off the miss. Here we go again. On the other end, Salit. Puts the ball in his hip, puts it in, and that's how they've gotten it done. A lot of runouts here. You know what? That Greenville defense has not gotten set since they got burned there at the end of the first half.
Well, it's a 10-2 run to start this third quarter, but you include the final minute of the second quarter, it's a 16-3 run.
Wow.
Calhoun County, 5-for-5 from the floor here in the second half, and their overall game field goal percentage now close to 57%, while Greenville is now below 37%.
And the star, Jamal McKee, 5-of-7 shooting. Great defense here by Taylor. The Cougars playing well.
Foul on McKee. And that spells trouble. McKee not only is struggling with his shot, he's 5-for-17 from the floor and 1-for-5 on his threes. He's now picked up his third personal foul. Solik's pass. Bounces off McKee. McKee scoops it ahead for the layup by Henry. Dejon Williams got stripped. The foul's going to be called on Greenville. That'll be the second team foul on the Patriots here in this second half. That puts Dejon Williams at the line. Tamarcus Jackson was called for his second foul. Williams now 3-for-3 at the foul line. John Williams now with 6 points, 4-for-4 at the stripe. Tamarcus Jackson. Nobody boxes out McKee.
He just threw one guy aside and he knocked over another Calhoun County player.
It's kind of like dominoes. They tried to box him out. He just got physical with it. So Lee scoops it. Dejon Williams misses the shot. And Tamarcus Jackson up the floor for Greenville. And a foul is going to be called on Calhoun County. Quentin Taylor gambled for the steal and gets whistled for the foul. That'll be number 4 on him.
That is
big. Huge.
Yeah.
You going to leave him on the floor, Larry?
Looks like he's going to.
Wow.
Coach Shaw.
Well, that was Henry who knocks down the shot. Greenville has cut it to 2. Well, Quentin Taylor is going to have to be very careful.
Coach Shaw's got a replacement coming in right here. Joshua Walls. That Kadarius Holmes. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Just a freshman.
That is a big substitution right there with Quentin Taylor and his 18 points and floor leadership having to leave the floor. Ball thrown away. Greenville a chance to tie. And Henry got stripped by DeAndre Scott. Great speed by DeAndre Scott to recover and prevent the layup.
Yeah, great play right there. Good defense here. Love this back and forth by both players.
Oh, tried to save it in. Nice job.
Off the inbounds. And Calhoun County comes away with it.
It was a great play drawn up there by the coach. Tenney just couldn't get it to go.
Sherrod Williams got his man in the air. Off back iron. Ball knocked out of bounds by Greenville. So Rashawn Williams will check in. Kadarius Holmes, the freshman, comes out. We'll see who runs the point.
Four fouls. We have a long way to go here. Almost 12 minutes in this game.
And stolen by Henry, but he can't save it from going out of bounds.
You know, also Greenville's full court defense really came off a lot of made shots. They haven't done that, and so as a result, they haven't had the full court pressure that they had enjoyed in the first half.
Sherrod Williams with the basket. Scott with the assist. Ahead, Henry traveled.
Oh, look at this. Nice look right here. Great job right there. The throw inside, the pass inside. By Deontay Scott. Good look. And Williams with the finish.
So Scott moves to the point with Quentin Taylor out of the ballgame. And they're having clock issues all over the place. The scoreboard above the floor is totally whacked. And then the clock above the basket down here for Greenville is totally off. Williams inside, that's travel. To John Williams, you gotta put the ball on the floor. There's the clock that's not working above the Greenville basket now. Unfortunately, there's no shot clock that you have to worry about in high school basketball. McKee in the paint. Been a long time since McKee made a bucket. Jackson the miss, rebound, Calhoun County, Sherrod Williams. You got to specify when you say Williams with Calhoun County. They got four Williams on the team. And that's one of them, DeJohn Williams. He's got eight. Tamarcus Jackson banks in the runner. Jackson keeping him in the game. He's now got 15. Trouble with the inbounds, and they get it to DeAndre Scott.
Nice job by Calhoun County, keeping Greenville on their heels defensively, that 2-3 zone.
John Williams gets his own miss and gets fouled, and he'll go to the line.
And DeJohn Williams has really come alive here. Nice job. Very active offensively.
Foul's called on Tamarcus Jackson, and that's number four on him. Well, it was inevitable, Larry. You can't play at this type pace, this type speed, and this kind of contact without the fouls finally catching up with you. We might have second and third teamers deciding the outcome of the state championship
that's
game.
That's right. That's right. Well, and Jackson comes out of the game. Renault Griffin also out of the game. So now a test for this Greenville team to see how deep you are. That big advantage you had, you controlled the whole first half, almost the entire first half, but right now, down by four.
John Williams rolls it in, 5-point lead for Calhoun County. Three ball. They had a hard time shooting the three ball. Greenville, not much success behind the arc. Sherrod Williams. And a foul, and Sherrod Williams will be going to the line.
Well, on the other side, too, Greenville has yet to, after scoring 24 points in the paint the entire first half, they have none here in the third quarter. And conversely, on the other side, it's Calhoun that's driving to the rim with abandon.
and are scoring at will inside. It's been a tale of two halves, beginning with those final 30 seconds in the first half of those two fast break layups by Taylor.
15th point of the afternoon for Sherrod Williams. Foul was called on Karan Tenney, his first. Five team fouls now on Greenville. Seven puts you in the bonus. Offensive rebound lost. That's going to be a foul called on Rashawn Williams. Or is it going to be on Greenville?
Yeah.
Wow. I thought Rashawn Williams would have been called over the back as he came in to get that offensive rebound, but it goes the other way. Calhoun County beat Irwin County 69-53 in the first round. Dooley County 72-52 in the quarterfinals, and Troutland 87-67 in the semifinals. And Greenville defeated Lanier County in the first round, Portal in the quarters, Hancock Central in the semifinals. And your road to the championships brought to you by Georgia EMC.
Stoppage in play right there. The scorer's table, they weren't quite sure who the foul was called on. It was on Middlebrooks of Greenville.
Deontay Scott, the inbounds, comes to Rashawn Williams. Next foul puts Calhoun County in the bonus. Next foul on Greenville. DeJohn Williams with the left hand.
Again, Calhoun County just scoring inside.
This is the largest lead for Calhoun County at 8 points.
20 points here in the third quarter. 12 have come inside the paint.
Yeah, we've had a 15-point swing since the final minute of the second quarter when Greenville had a 7-point lead with 60 seconds to play. Calhoun County erased it, made it one at halftime, and they've rolled out an extra 9 points on Greenville here in the third quarter. Sherrod Williams the foul. That's three on him. Four team fouls on Calhoun County. McKee loses the dribble. Out of control. Calhoun County run out. Marquez Willis blew the layup. And a blocking foul on Sherrod Williams and Calhoun County. Actually, Deontay Scott. Pardon me.
Tell you what, that's a real tough call, and you can understand why the Calhoun County fans don't like this. Here's Quan Terry here. His feet were moving. That's why, again, it goes against Calhoun County. But Tenney was also out of control, gets bailed out there by the moving feet of the defender, Williams.
Foul is called on Deontay Scott.
Oh, Scott, I apologize. And for the first time, we see a towel on the floor because there have been bodies going all over the place. It's very warm in here, almost a packed house for the second game of the day.
Yeah, it was 77 degrees outside, if you can believe it. I know folks up in North Georgia can't believe that. 77 here in Macon before the game. Ball pinballs around. And a foul is going to be called on Greenville. Snelling fell on top of Sherrod Williams.
But those are the kinds of plays that went Greenville's way in the first half. Calhoun County now with the extra energy, diving on the floor for loose balls and making things happen, and now they're in the bonus.
DeJohn Williams, at the line. Calhoun County now up nine.
Matt, what an amazing turn. And it goes back to, again, that final 30 seconds, the two fast break layups by Quentin Taylor to end the first half.
And they've been doing this without Quentin Taylor, who picked up his fourth personal foul here in the third quarter. DeJohn Williams now with 9 points here in the third. Strip and a foul on Marquez Willis.
Willis in the game because of Taylor's absence.
Hard to imagine that they have been able to pull away from Greenville in this third quarter with Quentin Taylor on the bench, but that's exactly what they've been able to do. He started the rally, and they've continued it without him.
By the way, the clock above the Greenville basket still inoperable.
Jermon Middlebrook to the foul line. Rebound, Sherrod Williams. Foul called on Middlebrooks.
Yeah, Calhoun doing a much better job here of handling this Greenville press, which has not been the same, again, because they're just not making shots right now. And Calhoun County beginning to make their free throws. We talked about early on how they really struggled at the line. Did a much better job of following through. Trying to put the ball in the basket from the line.
Dejon Williams at the line. 13 points, 5 rebounds. 9 of those 13 points in this quarter. And he's been cleaning up at the foul line, too. He's now got 14. 8 of 9 at the foul line. As Calhoun County has turned what was once a 7-point deficit with a minute to play in the second quarter into an 11-point lead with 36 seconds to play here in the third quarter. Henry, the miss. McKee, the rebound, stick back. Just the fourth point of the quarter for McKee. He's got 18. Seven seconds, Willis. Nobody boxes out Williams.
Great job right there again. These are the things Calhoun County, everything going right now for the Cougars, and a huge lead going into the fourth quarter.
Calhoun County gunning for their first state title since 1997. A big third quarter to open an 11-point lead on the Greenville Patriots.
High school students and parents, going to college is expensive. But at College Goal Georgia events, students can get help filling out the free application for federal student aid to get money for college. Participants can also enter to win an iPad. Visit collegegoalga.com.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
It's been said that championships aren't won by individuals. They're won with team and teamwork. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association Athletics. In all of our county farm bureaus across the state, we have a championship team ready to deliver services to you and your family and all of Georgia farmers across this state. We invite you to come to your local County Farm Bureau and be part of our team. Go team!
Visit us online at gfb.org.
Hey, great party.
Oh, thanks. Here you go. One hamburger, medium well.
This is well done.
No. That's medium well.
What? Are you calling me a liar? This thing is practically burnt.
That's it. You're not going to come to my house and tell me how to cook a hamburger.
You wouldn't do it there.
You gotta be crazy.
So don't do it here. Sportsmanship. It's up to you.
That back at the Macon Centralplex Class Single A Boys Public Championship game. We got Calhoun up 69-58 going to the fourth quarter. Greenville coach, I'm sure, spending some time with his team right now. We talked with him. We talked about the fact that he grew up not far away from Greenville, that Walter Jackson went to Manchester High School. But when he got the job at Greenville, the people there said they didn't know who he was. His brother-in-law had been a coach at that school for some time. He had been a coach at Spencer High School. But now the crowd knows who he is. The players know who he is. And he's trying to rally them to see if they can come back and get back into this ball game here in the fourth quarter.
Well, Sam, his team down 11 points as we start the fourth quarter after Calhoun County outscored Greenville 25-13, Larry, in that third quarter, outshot them 64% to 33% and outscored them 16-8 in the paint.
Well, and another thing, too, Greenville, 16 points off turnovers in the first half, only two in that third quarter. And so we've got a delay right now. Again, they're trying to get this scoreboard fixed. As you can see, the one above, you get a shot of it. That's what's been over the head, over the court right here, center court. It's now completely out. We also have the clock is back on over the Greenville basket. That was out for most of the third quarter, but a lot of scoreboard issues right now. So these teams are going to begin play. They're going to depend upon the two scoreboards that are at each end of the court is what they'll be looking at. But the one overhead right now, they just completely turned off. It has been inactive for most of the game, Matt.
Well, Quentin Taylor, their star of the first half, who scored 18 points but picked up his fourth personal foul in that third quarter, starts the fourth quarter on the bench. They have been able to survive with Taylor on the bench because DeJohn Williams, 14 points, 8 of 10 at the foul line in that third quarter, and Sherrod Williams with 15 points and 6 rebounds overall have carried them in his absence. And Deontay Scott has run the point. That's Scott with the ball. Sherrod Williams. Williams sticks with it. And Rashawn Williams sticks it in. He's got six.
Again, just good energy, more active. They want it more right now. They can sense the state championship coming in. Up 13 at this point. McKee, his shot has been off. Trying to make something happen, but it can't get it.
There's the dunk by Griffin. Just his first point of the game. Meantime, McKee, to follow up on what you're talking about, is now 7 for 21 shooting in this game. And starting to force it.
Yeah, 1 of 6 and 3 as well.
They need McKee to penetrate on offense like he was doing in the first half. That's when he was most effective. Deontay Scott launching a three. Another offensive rebound for Calhoun County. Calhoun County been doing a good job on the offensive glass. That's their 12th offensive board.
The other side right now, look at this. This is, again, Henry trying to make something happen. There's a nice dunk there. Griffin putting it in. But right now, take a look at Greenville and just their body language right now. They look tired. They're not getting the turnovers. They're not getting the shots to go. And you wonder right now, Matt, I wonder right now if they've got tired legs. Their shots aren't falling. They're not rotating well on defense. They're getting out-hustled with the balls.
Sometimes, like we said, the best way to beat a pressing team or a team that likes to run is to press the pressing team, you run the running team, and sometimes they can't handle their own medicine. Fatigue would explain 33% shooting in the third quarter. Pass deflected out of bounds by DeJohn Williams.
Well, they're 2 of 15 shooting from 3. They were 0 for 5 in that third quarter.
McKee cutting to the basket. That's exactly what I was talking about on the last possession. He needs to get in the lane, get himself some easy points, get his game going again.
Well, and see there, that was the best, although Calhoun County breaks it pretty easily. That was the best press that Greenville's had in the second half. Right there, off to McKee make.
Tip in by McKee. Two quick baskets by McKee. He's got 22 points. And Marcus Shaw calls a timeout for Calhoun County as Greenville's back to within seven.
That's a really good timeout right there because, again, you see the field momentum shifting back over to Greenville, and it's all because of Jamal McKee. Watch this on the replay again. Snelling with a nice outlet right here. Teddy can't get it to go, but McKee, to your point, he's right there. And like you said, Matt, that's what you need him to do. The basket on the inbounds, and then right here, the tip, and that set up, again, a couple of the two. That's what they want. They want him scoring inside, and then he's right there setting up the point man on that 1-2-2 full court press.
I'll be willing to bet you he just got a layup. He got a tip in. If he takes a three here soon, he'll knock it down because he's got his confidence back. Yeah. That's what you need to do.
Yeah.
You don't get your confidence back missing three-pointers. You get your confidence back scoring easy buckets, and then you step back outside and try the three-point shot again.
Well, I tell you this, Greenville, no more slumped shoulders after a couple of baskets. And look who's back in the game now for Calhoun County. Taylor back in with four fouls.
Stolen by Henry. McKee inside. Six straight points for Jamal McKee. Greenville back in the game, down by five. Another steal. Tenney, the miss, and there's the jam by Griffin. Griffin with the jam, his second of the quarter. And a timeout called by Calhoun County as Greenville makes their run after falling down by 11. They're down three.
Yeah, watch this again. We talked about, again, the press, and all of a sudden, there it is. Taylor, like you said, you can't go up in the air without somewhere to go. Henry, with a nice look, gets it to McKee. 6 points for him all of a sudden, very quickly. And then once again, the bad throw there, the turnover. Tinney can't get it to go, and watch out of nowhere. Was he in the cylinder right there? No call, but that's a questionable shot right there. Is that in high school, is that a call in the cylinder on that dunk?
Well, there's no replay in high school basketball, That's a dunk for Renault Griffin.
One more look right here. It's a fantastic athletic play right here by Renault Griffin, but let's see if the ball is in the cylinder. I think it is, but to your point, Matt, there's no replay. But listen, take nothing away from what Greenville has done and Renault Griffin. McKee with 6 points very quickly right now, and all of a sudden, a team that had no life just 90 seconds ago is right back in this game. It's a three-point game with this 10-0 run.
So quickly, Greenville has erased what appeared to be a deficit in a game that was slipping away from them. Again, the full court pressures.
Steps out of bounds.
Quentin Taylor back in the ball game after sitting for nearly a quarter, and he steps on the sidelines.
We just talked about, what, only 2 points off turnovers or up in that third quarter. They've got, what, six here in the last 90 seconds, eight maybe? And trying to add to it.
Henry inside, shot defensed, and Sherrod Williams comes up with it.
Great block by Deshaun Williams.
Taylor. Great drive, didn't get the layup. McKee with his hands on the ball. Out of control. Whips it inside to Griffin. Greenville has fought all the way back. They're down only one. Williams, the drive. Shot blocked. Foul call. To Marcus Jackson, that would be number five on him.
That's a big loss for Greenville.
So to Marcus Jackson, the senior, fouls out of his last high school basketball game.
And he knew it right away. Got him on the arm, no question. Saw the team leader, Quan Tenney. Classmate, fellow senior, talking to him right then. Selling back in the game to replace him. He's a jump shooter who has not shot well, just 1 of 8 on the first three quarters.
Jackson finishes the night with 15 points. Williams knocks down the first free throw. Calhoun County, 17 of 28 at the foul line. They've taken 12 more free throw attempts than Greenville. make it 13 and a two-point lead for Calhoun County. Griffin inside to Snelly.
Good defense by Calhoun County. I like Greenville's patience though on offense in that set right there.
Willis can't control it. McKee ends up with it. McKee for the tie. Actually cut it down to one, pardon me, the three-point lead. Taylor. Griffin missed the block. Good defense anyway. Now McKee for the lead. Gets his own miss for the lead again. And Taylor the rebound. McKee had two good looks on that possession. Williams. Henry the rebound for Greenville. Henry. The miss. Got his own miss. Sticks it in. Greenville back on top for the first time since 45-44.
What a rally. Both these teams right now bringing a lot of energy as you'd expect. It's like it was in the first quarter again. Up and down.
Williams offensive foul. Sherrod Williams called for the offensive foul. Renaught Griffin stood in there and took the punishment.
Well, we're going back to, again, the Greenville full court press. Now they're actually making baskets to bring the press on. It's, again, Calhoun County that's out of control on offense. And Williams right there, out of control, made the pass, but couldn't stop his body. That was an easy call on the charge.
Tenney breaks down the defense, dumps it to Griffin. 16-team run for Greenville. They storm back from 11 down to take a three-point lead.
And Coach Shaw, Calhoun County, is hot. Doesn't like his defense, yelling at his players right now. Again, nice job right there. That's what penetration does. Take it inside. Great job by the senior, Tenney. Dejon Williams doesn't stay home. It's the easy stuff right there for Griffin. One more look at it coming right into the living room. What a run right now by Greenville. And again, it all goes back to that defense and the frenetic pace they created. They started again with more energy and have taken the momentum away from Calhoun County, which has really controlled this game for much of the second half. It's the pendulum now has swung back over to the Greenville Patriots.
What a fourth quarter for Nalt Griffin. All eight of his points here in the first less than 5 minutes of this quarter, including three dunks. McKee and Griffin have combined for 16 points, eight apiece in this fourth quarter. As Greenville outscored 25-13 in the third quarter, Larry, has outscored Calhoun County 18-4 in the first 4 minutes and 54 seconds of this fourth quarter.
Well, you know, we were looking at a 90-point game at halftime. It's 45-44. A little more defense is on both. The scoring is down here in the second half.
We might still get the 90.
I think we still could. A lot of time. Way these two go.
Taylor goes by Tibby. They get it down to Salit. Back to Taylor. Taylor tied up. Still muscles it up and in. First points for Taylor after scoring 18 in the first half. Remember, he spent more than a quarter on the bench with foul trouble. That's an over and back, and he missed it. McKee. They missed the over and back right here. Watch this. Over, back.
Oh, but he kept 1 foot. Can you straddle in high school?
Now, he took both feet back, though. He straddled, then he took both feet back over, yeah. Williams inside the arc, the miss, rebound, Snelly loses the dribble. Williams hops on top of it. And a jump ball called, possession arrow pointing in favor of Greenville.
Love the pace. Ooh, the Greenville fans all standing. Calhoun County as well.
Packed house here at the Macon Coliseum. Timmy, same play again, this time they get over to defensive Salit with the block. Williams to Williams, to John Williams, sticks it in. Calhoun County back on top.
Nice patience right there by Sherrod Williams to find Dejon Williams.
Rebound Salit. Now Calhoun County with the 1-point lead and less than 2 minutes to play, and a foul called on Greenville. Snelling is second.
Watch the nice patience right here. Salit gets it to Williams right here. Nice hesitation dribble. Stops, waits, gets the trailer on the secondary break. That's just good, smart basketball right there by the Williams boys.
Yeah, and Larry, that's something they were not doing in the first half. They were just aggressive and going full speed and not waiting for the play to come. Sherrod Williams at the foul line.
Love the energy, the atmosphere here. 1:42 to go. State championship on the line. This is, like you said, Matt, where we thought we would be. Tight game toward the end.
Williams just 4 of 11 at the foul line, but he gives Calhoun County a 2-point lead. McKee. Basket. We'll see if they count it, or the foul may have come before the basket.
He's going to count it. Chance for a 3-point play.
So we're tied at 78.
A good, smart play right here by Henry. The Calhoun County fans wanting to travel there by McKee. Thought he kind of shuffled his feet there, but he caught the pass. But we're seeing now again here at the clutch, final couple of minutes, good patience by both sides. Henry there had a shot at a three. He waited, found McKee. Get it to your big man. Chance for a 3-point play and the lead.
Yeah, foul was called on Ross. He'll come out. John Williams comes back in. This is our fifth tie of the night. 78-78, 92 seconds to play. McKee, after a pedestrian third quarter, which has scored only 4 points, now has 11 in this quarter. And a game-high 29. Williams all the way with the left hand, gingerly rolls it in. Calhoun County up one. 20 for him, stolen by Williams. Stripped by Tinney. Tinney all the way. Greenville back on top by one. What a game. What a tremendous single-A boys public state championship game.
Boy, this is just exciting. Watch this here. Tenney again makes the bad pass and makes up with it for it there with a great strip back to the lane. And watch this. He's got options. Just decides to split the defenders. The defenders stayed home at both those players to see where he's going to pass the ball. Nice job right here by Tenney. Get the ball back. But watch from this angle. The defenders take away his two passing options, so he takes it in himself. And it's Greenville back on top by one. Matt, what a way to start. This is just game two right here.
It's been 18 years since Calhoun County won the state championship. It's been 23 years since Greenville won a state championship. One of those teams will finally break that drought here tonight. Wilkinson County has held a death grip on the single-A bracket, having won two straight and three of the last four, but we get a new state championship and new state champion this year.
What a thrilling game, and 66 seconds to go. This thing isn't over.
Greenville 11 of 21 shooting from the floor in the fourth quarter. Calhoun only 4 of 12 as they have surrendered an 11-point lead.
And Greenville with no press.
They drop back into a zone. Offensive putback miss. Ball kept alive and last touch by McKee, so Calhoun County gets it with 51 seconds. Calhoun County down a point.
Taylor with the ball with four fouls. He's done a nice job of not picking up that fifth foul.
Taylor drives, Williams puts it in. Calhoun County up one with 41 seconds. McKee in the paint. Shot contested, Griffin will go to the line. Big fourth quarter for Renault Griffin. He has been a huge part of this Greenville Patriots comeback.
Been very active. We talked about, again, some of the players, Greenville players, seem to have been spent early in the fourth quarter. Defensively, the big spark.
Quentin Taylor just fouled out. He finishes the night with 20. And now Renault Griffin, 8 points, state championship on the line, just a 50% free throw shooter.
I tell you what, he did not look comfortable in that shot at all.
There's Quentin Taylor. He'll have to watch the rest of this game. For the tie. 82-82. How about Renault Griffin? Scoreless for three quarters, steps up with 9 points here in this fourth quarter, Larry. Three thunderous, meaningful dunks and a free throw to tie it with 28.2 left in the biggest game of the season.
Yeah, how about the emotion for Griffin? Number 21, watch him right here. There's a slam, puts that one in, and then off the miss. Goes up, and once again here, great dish by Tenney. Bring it down the house on that one. This young man, the 6'1 junior, but imagine the emotions, like you said. You know that free throw shooting is not something you're real strong at. You missed the first one, you know what's on the line, but stepping up, deep breath, and put that second one in to tie the ball game here with 28 seconds. This has just been thrilling for both sides. I think if you're a fan of either team, you've got to be excited the way your team has played, competed, fought, and worked, and scrapped to have it shot here with 28 seconds for a state championship.
So Calhoun County has the ball, 28 seconds in an 82-82 game. We'll see if Greenville full court presses here, drops back into their half court. Looks like it's going to be a full court press. If you're Calhoun County, are you playing for the final shot here in regulation?
You know what? Without Quentin Taylor, that's tough. With Quentin Taylor, I think you do. Now, at this point, you try to get the ball inbounds first.
Sherrod Williams brings it up. Scott with the ball. Williams. Sherrod Williams. Looks like they're playing for a final shot. 10 seconds. DeJohn Williams in the paint. And it goes with 5 seconds. McKee, quick inbounds to Timmy. Timmy for the championship. Calhoun County, the state champions for the first time since 1997. Calhoun County, the class single-A public school champions. The John Williams, who broke his leg playing football in the fall, their leading scorer a year ago, leads them to the state title, their first in 18 years.
What a game for Calhoun County. Any surprise that a Williams, with four Williams on the court, that a Williams would get it done? And what a second half he had.
18 points for the John Williams. Calhoun County with a dramatic 84-82 victory over Greenville, played for the final shot and knocked down the game winner with 5 seconds on the clock. Congratulations to the Calhoun County Cougars.